discuss cholesterol management guidelines, updated guidelines given by ACC 2018-19. Let's quickly revise the class of recommendation and the level of evidence. Class 1, which is strongly recommended, there are more benefits than risks. It's highly recommended, indicated, useful, and very effective. It should be performed or administered. Okay. Class 2 is moderately recommended. But there are benefits. The evidence is reasonable, can be useful, can be effective. Class 2B has a weak recommendation, may or might be reasonable, can be considered. And class 3 has no benefit, is not recommended, but there are some data but should not be performed at administered. Class 3 has harm, not recommended, potentially harmful. Okay. Level of evidence, level A, B, and C. Level A says that there are high quality evidence and there are more than one randomized controlled trials for it. Level B says trials are there, one or more trials are there, but has moderate quality evidence. B, NR, there are no non-randomized trials, and C, level C has limited data. There are no trials as such, but meta-analysis of such studies are there. And level C has expert opinion only. There are no trials on performed. Now start with the measurement of LDL-C and non-HDL-C cholesterol. Non-HDL-C means VLDL and LDL both combined. What recommendation says that class of recommendation 1 and level of evidence B, but non-randomized trials are there. In adults who are aged 20 years and older and not on any lipid lowering therapy, measurement of either a fasting or non-fasting plasma lipid profile is effective in estimating the atherosclerotic risk, cardiovascular risk, and documenting the baseline LDL-C. And another recommendation says that 20 years of age or older patient people in whom an initiating non-fasting lipid profile reveals a triglyceride level of more than 400 or higher, a repeat lipid profile in the fasting state should be performed for assessment of the fasting triglyceride levels and baseline LDL-C. These are the class 1 recommendations for measurement.
This has to be told to the pathologist, because all of them push back a patient when he goes for a random sample. And every time I get a woman, still they every time push the
last
hero doesn't know.
Sir, requisition for non-fasting lipid profile of one doina mokli sir. Requisition for non-fasting lipid profile
of one. Toi
nahi karega. Toi logic of toi bondai
chau. Toi logic of toi bondai
chau. Nichi se baithi ho chani bondai bhoog chau. Chai se kitli garam hiu chau.
Haan, ye baat sati.
Ye baat sati.
They
don't convey this. Including Dr. Lokmani, I have told Harshukh Bhai down to Tushar, they possibly don't convey or those guys don't listen. They don't want to follow the protocol. And for 10 years I have been doing this, before this game, because I want to get an idea in the education, you don't go 3 times, come go 3 times. You know,
I'm
going to
say, yes, sir. For any recommendation.
Yes, sir. For screening, this is non-fasting, and then if triglycerides levels are more than 400.
Whether it is 400, you don't need to worry. There is no problem to
you.
Can you reach LDL in that report you will consider, direct or measured? Calculated.
Fred Weil's formula is there, indirect measurement, but more effective is direct LDL-C levels. Are more effective.
So all guidelines or the cutoff that you are mentioning here is of direct one or
measured one? Direct one, sir.
Direct.
Direct LDL-C levels. Yes. Moving on to the class 2A recommendations of measurement of LDL-C and levels. For patients, now says that LDL-C levels less than 70 milligrams per deciliter, measurement of direct LDL-C or modified LDL-C is reasonable to improve the accuracy over the Friedwald's formula, sir, as I said. But this is a class 2A recommendation, still recommend, highly recommended. And another recommendation says that adults who are 20 years of age or older and without a personal history of any cardiovascular disease, but with, who has a family history of premature atherosclerotic disease or genetic hypertriglyceridemia, measurement of fasting lipid profile is reasonable as a part of initial evaluation screening to aid in the understanding and identification of familial lipid disorders. So this is a two-way recommendation but has a limited data as such. Now, we'll discuss the secondary prevention and primary prevention of atherosclerosis and what are the guidelines says. Now, class 1 recommendation, which is very important for statin therapy use in patients who has atherosclerotic disease. In patients who are 75 years of age or younger with clinical disease, who has already documented disease, high intensity statin therapy should be initiated or continued with the aim of achieving a 50% or greater reduction in LDL-C levels from the baseline. This is a class 1 recommendation and level of evidence 8. There are so many randomized trials on this data, and this sentence is very important. 75 years of age and LDL-C levels has to be reduced by more than 50% who has documented atherosclerotic disease. Another recommendation says that in patients with clinical disease in whom the high intensity statin therapy is contraindicated or who experience a statin associated side effects, moderate intensity statin, you should reduce the intensity, should be initiated or continued with the aim of achieving a 30 to 40% 50% reduction in LDL-C levels. Okay, this is the second recommendation. It's also level 1 and level A recommendation.
Most of the time people do it the other way. They start with 10 milligrams and go to 20 and 15. They keep to start with 20 or 40 and come down.
Yes, first high intensity statin, if it is contraindicated or any side effect, so we can reduce with the 30 to 50% reduction in LDL-C levels. That is a target.
So this LDL level you mentioned is of baseline LDL level of index event for which LDL level?
Baseline LDL level, like on at the time of like patient presence. If the LDL-C is 200, then suppose 200 milligrams per deciliter, then 50% reduction.
So most of the time these data are not available. See, patient develop MIF50, he comes to me at 60 years of age. I need to give statin and 10 years data are not available. Then how will you target?
Then you
go to
absolute target.
Then absolute targets like for high risk group, very high risk group.
Yes sir,
there are so already you have an event and you would like to keep less than 55 or less than 70 in India.
Yes.
I think 70 is reasonable for you.
70 is reasonable, but now all guidelines are for very high risk group who has two back-to-back events, two cardiovascular events or cardiovascular events followed by stroke. Then target is more stringent, like less than 55, some guidelines is less than 45 also LDL. And many of patients, we must have seen that patient come to us with LDL of 60 and no side effects at all. So, reasonably to achieve.
Yes. Another secondary recommendation, atherosclerotic disease prevention recommendation, class 1 and level of evidence, there are non-randomized trials. In patients with clinical atherosclerotic disease, who are just to be very high risk and considered for PCSK9 inhibitor therapy, maximally tolerated LDL-C lowering therapy should include maximally tolerated statin therapy and ezetimibe. So this is a non-statin drug which should add to the patients who are very high risk and who are ideal for a PCSK9 inhibitor therapy but cannot be started because they are very costly drugs and are not easily available in India. Class 2 recommendation says that in patients with clinical atherosclerotic disease who are just to be very high risk and who are on maximally tolerated LDL-C lowering therapy with LDL-C levels 70 or higher or non-HDL-C level of 100 or higher, it is reasonable to add a PCSK9 inhibitor following a clinician patient discussion about the net benefits, safety, cost and everything. So this is a class 2 recommendation. Another recommendation says in patients with clinical disease who are on a maximally tolerated statin therapy and are judged to be very high risk, have an LDL-C of 70 or higher, it is reasonable to add ezetimibe therapy. There are randomized controlled trials, the level of evidence is B class and class of recommendation 2A. That's its benefit, gives benefit than the risk. Another slight recommendation for statin therapy, class 2 recommendations, these are class 2. In patients older than 75 years of age who has clinical disease, it is reasonable to add to initiate moderate or high intensity statin therapy after evaluation of the potential risk reduction, adverse effects and drug-drug interactions as well as patient frailty and patient preferences. is for 75 years of age, who has like more, they are more prone to side effects and drug interactions, who are comorbid patients. And another recommendation says that in such patients, 75 years of age or older, who are tolerating high intensity statin therapy, it's reasonable to continue the same therapy after an evaluation of the potential risk reduction, adverse effects, and drug interactions. Another recommendation, these are class 2B recommendations in patients who has atherosclerotic disease, who are receiving maximally tolerated statin therapy and whose LDL-C levels remain 70 or higher, you should add another non-statin drug, that is ezetimibe. Second recommendation, in patients with heart failure with reduced ejection fraction attributable to IHD, who have a reasonable life expectancy of 3 to 5 years and are not already on statin, clinicians may consider initiation of moderate intensity statin to reduce the occurrence of the atherosclerotic disease events.
Why not high intensity?
Yes, sir.
Why moderate intensity? Why not high intensity?
Sir, the recommendation says that who has a reasonable life expectancy of 3 to 5 years, who are very high mortality.
Is already having IHD, right? So, SCVD is
there. I don't remember the trials is that there is no morbidity benefit here. Beyond 3 to 5 years, there is no morbidity benefit if you have high intensity statin. That is why they have gone for moderate. Because they are not the ones to go for moderate at all.
What are the very high category for future atherosclerotic disease? This is a category of recent ACS within the past 12 months. When there is history of MI other than the recent ACS, history of ischemic stroke, symptomatic peripheral arterial disease, history of claudication with ankle brachial index less than 0.85, or previous revascularization or amputation treatment.
Recent ACS, then regardless of outcome, all ACS are high risk for future?
ACS, any kind of ACS are...
any kind, whether you are stented, whether you are thrombolized, whether the patient has normal LV, even after LV, then it is high risk?
Yes, sir. Yes.
It's yours?
Yes. Other high risk conditions are age more than 65 years, heterozygous familial hypercholesterolemia, history of prior coronary CMVG surgery or PCI outside of the major atherosclerotic disease events. DM, diabetic mellitus patients, hypertensive patients, CKD patients, smokers, when there is persistent elevated LDL-C levels of more than 100 despite the maximally tolerated statin therapy and ezetimibe. History of congestive heart failure, these are very high risk conditions. Yes.
More than 100 LDL-C persistent elevated.
Yes, sir. Who are on non-statin as well as statin drug. Now, severe hypercholesterolemia. When the LDL-C levels more than or equal to 190, what recommendation says that the class of recommendation 1 is in patients 20 to 75 years of age with an LDL-C level of 190 or higher, maximal tolerated statin therapy is recommended. Irrespective of the atherosclerotic disease events or any kind of risk, you should start maximally tolerated statin therapy straight away.
So for primary treatments?
Yes. In primary, in severe hypercholesterolemia, LDL-C levels this much. Class 2 recommendation says that same age group with an LDL-C level of more than 190 who achieves less than 50% reduction in LDL-C while receiving maximally tolerated statin therapy and or have an LDL-C level of 100 or higher, ezetimibe therapy is reasonable. You can start the ezetimibe therapy when there is less than 50% reduction in such patients. This is class 2 recommendation. Class 2 recommendation says for the severe hypercholesterolemia is that for the same age group, 20 to 75 years of age, with a baseline LDL-C level more than 190, who achieves less than 50% reduction and have fasting triglycerides levels are less than 300. While taking maximally tolerated statin therapy and ezetimibe, the addition of bile acid sequestrant may be considered. This comes the third drug here, when we can consider LDL-C levels and triglycerides levels. So you should add two drugs, statin, non-statin, and bile acid sequestrant. Class 2B recommendation another is that 30 to 75 years of age with heterozygous familial hypercholesterolemia, have LDL-C level of 100 or higher while taking maximally tolerated statin and ezetimibe therapy, the addition of another PCSK9 inhibitor may be considered. These are class 2B recommendations for severe hypercholesterolemia. Here we can add statin plus non-statin and bile acid sequestrant, another third drug. Now we come to the diabetes mellitus patients. What recommendation says? Class 1 recommendation for patients with DM, 40 to 75 years of age with diabetes mellitus, regardless of the estimated 10-year risk of atherosclerotic disease, moderate intensity statin therapy is indicated. This class 1 level of evidence A. Class 2 recommendation says in adults of same age group with diabetes mellitus and LDL-C levels of 70 to 190. It is reasonable to first assess the 10-year risk of atherosclerotic disease events to help stratify the risk. Another recommendation, class 2 recommendation in
patients. Yes, slide 7 or did it?
Yes, sir.
Class 1 level A evidence check.
Yes, sir.
You are not worried what level, what is the level of LDL?
Sir, actually, they are saying that we have to start statin. But it is reasonable to assess the risk. But you have to start statin. In the second line, they are not advising anything about statin. They have just.
In all guidelines, including AD4, ADA, ESP, everywhere, irrespective of the level of LDL,
yes.
In
yes.
Diabetes, you must
start statin. You must start statin. In after age of 40, yes. In diabetes, you must start statin.
Yes, sir. This is moderate intensity statin. Last one. Class 2 recommendation says that in adults with diabetes mellitus who have multiple atherosclerotic disease risk factors, it is reasonable to prescribe high intensity statin therapy with a target to reduce LDL-C levels by more than 50%. This class 2 recommendation. Another recommendation says in patients older than 75 years of age with diabetes mellitus and who are already on statin therapy, we should continue the statin therapy for such patients. Class 2 recommendation says that in adults with diabetes mellitus and 10-year atherosclerotic disease risk of 20% or higher, this is a very high risk category, it is reasonable to add ezetimibe to maximally tolerated statin therapy to reduce the target LDL-C levels by more than 50%. Another recommendation, these are class 2B with limited data. In adults of 75 years of age or older with diabetes mellitus, it may be reasonable to initiate statin therapy after a clinician-patient discussion of potential benefits and risks of starting the treatment. And another recommendation for age group of 20 to 39 years of age with diabetes mellitus, that is either of long duration, when there is albuminuria, estimated GFR less than 60, retinopathy, neuropathy, ankle brachial index less than 0.9, we should start, it may be reasonable to initiate the statin therapy. This is a class 2B recommendations which has a limited data. Risk enhancing factors for clinician patient risk discussion. Family history of premature atherosclerotic disease, primary hypercholesterolemia, metabolic syndrome, chronic kidney disease patients, patient who has chronic inflammatory disorders like psoriasis or rheumatoid arthritis, history of premature menopause or history of pregnancy associated conditions that increase and later increase the atherosclerotic risk such as preeclampsia, high risk race and ethnicities South Asian population. These are the risk enhancing factors. Continuing that, what are the lipid biomarkers with increased risk? Persistently elevated triglycerides levels, the value is more than 175, and if measured, high sensitivity CRP is more than 2. Elevated lipoproteins A level is more than 50, which constitutes a risk enhancing factor. A polyprotein B more than 130. And ankle brachial index 0.9. These are the risk enhancing factors for atherosclerotic disease. Primary prevention of adults 40 to 75 years of age with LDL-C levels of 70 to 190. what primary prevention recommendation says, class of recommendation, in adults at an intermediate risk, statin therapy reduces the risk of atherosclerotic disease. And in the context of risk discussion, if a decision is made for statin therapy, a moderate intensity statin therapy should be recommended. This is when the LDL-C level 70 to 190 and in primary prevention, who doesn't have disease but they are more prone to disease. Another recommendation says that in intermediate risk patients, LDL-C level should be reduced by 30% or more, and for optimal risk reduction, especially in high risk patients, level should be reduced by 50% or more. Here we should calculate the 10-year atherosclerotic disease risk. There are calculators available. Less than 5% risk is low, mild risk. 7.5 to 10% is moderate risk category. More than 20% is very high risk category. 10-year risk for atherosclerotic disease.
There is no mention of the HDL levels. If they are very high, 80-100, then there is no mention that you should start with a lesser intensity or something.
So ratio is not important.
No, sir.
Please can say that
they are mainly focused on LDL and non-HDL C levels. Another recommendation for primary prevention in adults of 40 to 75 years of age who has LDL-C levels of 70 to 190. Class 1 recommendations, but there are non-randomized controlled trials. For primary prevention of atherosclerotic disease in age group of 40 to 75 years of age without the diabetes mellitus and LDL-C levels of 70 to 190, 10-year atherosclerotic risk has to be calculated. With using the race and sex specific PC pooled cohort estimated calculators, and adults should be categorized as being the low risk, less than 5%, borderline risk 5 to 75%, intermediate risk more than 75 to 20%, and very high risk category that constitutes more than 20%. Clinicians and patients should engage in a risk discussion. They consider risk factors, adherence to healthy lifestyle, the potential for atherosclerotic disease, risk reduction benefits, and potential for adverse effects and drug interactions, as well as patient safety preferences. So these are class 1 recommendations to initiate the statin therapy. First calculate the atherosclerotic disease risk, and then discuss the everything with the relatives about the drug interactions or patient preferences, healthy lifestyle for primary prevention. Another recommendations, class 2 recommendation says that for adults 40 to 75 and LDL-C levels same 70 to 190, in intermediate risk adults, that is category of 7.5 to 20% risk, risk enhancing factors favor initiation or intensification of statin therapy. Another recommendation says that in intermediate risk or selected borderline risk adults, if the decision about statin use remain uncertain, it is reasonable to use a CAC score, that is coronary artery calcification score, if in the decision to withhold or postpone or initiate the statin therapy. These recommendations are for primary prevention. Another recommendation says for the same age group with the LDL levels 70 to 190, class 2 recommendations, in intermediate risk adults or selected borderline risk adults in whom a CAC score which is measured for the purpose of making a treatment decision, if the coronary calcium score is zero, it is reasonable to withhold the statin therapy and reassess the 5 to 10 years risk as long as the high risk conditions are absent, like diabetes mellitus, hypertension, family history of CHD or cigarette smoking. This is for selected borderline risk adults who has a risk of 5 to 7.5% 10 year risk of atherosclerotic disease. If the CAC score is 1 to 99, it is reasonable to initiate the statin therapy for patients of more than 55 years of age. And if the CAC score is 100 or higher, or in the 75th percentile or higher, it is reasonable to start the statin therapy straight away. Another recommendations, class 2B recommendations for the same age group, LDL-C levels of 70 to 190. In intermediate risk adults who would benefit from more aggressive LDL-C lowering therapy and in whom high intensity statins are advisable but not acceptable or tolerated, it is reasonable to add a non on statin drug, ezetimibe or 5-ALC6 equivalent to a moderate intensity statin who are not tolerating the very high intensity statin dose. Second recommendation says that in patients at borderline risk, in risk discussion, the presence of risk enhancing factors may justify initiation of moderate statin therapy. We discussed the risk enhancing factors. So we should start based on that the moderate intensity statin therapy in patients of adults 40 to 75 years of age with LDL-C levels of 70 to 190 at the presentation. Now, how will we monitor the LDL-C lowering response to LDL-C lowering therapy? Class 1, recommendation 1, level of evidence A. So, the adherence to changes in lifestyle and effects of LDL-C lowering medication should be assessed by measurement of the fasting lipids and appropriate safety indicators 4 to 12 weeks after starting of the statin therapy, and dose adjustment every 3 to 12 months thereafter based on the need to assess the adherence and safety considering the other risk factors. So 4 to 12 months after statin initiation evaluation and dose adjustment every 3 to 12 months thereafter based on the side effects and safety and patient's adherence to the medication. This is class 1 recommendation. Primary prevention we discuss in LDL-C 70 to 190 with 40 to 75, and these are the other age groups like older adults 75 years of age with an LDL-C level of 70 to 190. Initiating a moderate intensity statin is may be reasonable, class 2 be recommendation, 75 years of age. Another recommendation says for the same age group that it may be reasonable to stop statin therapy when functional decline, that's physical, cognitive, multimorbidity is there, frailty or reduced life expectancy limits the potential benefits of statin therapy. Class 2 recommendation, we should stop the statin therapy in adults more than 75 years of age who has high morbidity and functionally incapable bedridden patients. Another recommendation says that in adults 76 to 80 years of age with an LDL-C level of 70 to 190, it may be reasonable to measure the coronary artery calcification score to reclassify those with CAC score of 0 to avoid the statin therapy. Primary prevention in children and adults. This class 1 recommendation, level of evidence, more randomized trials are available. In children and adolescents with lipid disorders, familial or genetic disorders related to obesity, it is recommended to intensify the lifestyle therapy including moderate calorie restriction, regular aerobic physical activity. Basically, lifestyle modification at an early age is advisable. Another recommendation says that in adults and adolescents with lipid abnormalities, lifestyle counseling is beneficial for lowering LDL-C. These are the counseling and the lifestyle modification. Primordial prevention is advised, class 1 recommendation. Another primary prevention in children and adolescents, class 2 recommendations. Now here they say that 10 years of age or older with LDL-C levels persistently above 190 or higher, or 160 or higher with a clinical presentation consistent with familial hypercholesterolemia and who do not respond adequately with 3 to 6 months of lifestyle therapy, we should start studying. The level of recommendation said that first lifestyle modification advice, but after even after that, after 3 to 6 months, LDL levels are more than 190 or 160 with the clinical effects, we should start statin therapy in children above 10 years of age or older. Class 2 recommendations, another is says that in adults and adolescents with a family history of either CVD or significant hypercholesterolemia, we should start, it is reasonable to measure a fasting and non-fasting LPL levels as early as stage age 2 years to detect the familial disease or rare forms of hypercholesterolemia. Another recommendation for the same age group, children and adolescents, class 2 recommendation says that children found to have moderate or severe hypercholesterolemia, it is reasonable to carry out a reverse cascade screening of family members, which include the cholesterol testing for second, third degree relative, biological relatives for detection of familial forms of genetic disorders regarding cholesterol. Class 2 recommendation says another that children and adolescents with obesity or other metabolic risk factors, it is reasonable to measure a fasting lipid profile to detect lipid disorders as a component of the metabolic syndrome. shown that in adults 20 years of age or older with moderate hypertriglyceridemia, fasting on non-fasting triglycerides 175 to 500, this moderate category, mild is less than 175, normal is less than 150, and very high category more than 500. Clinicians should address the and treat the lifestyle factors, obesity and metabolic syndrome, secondary factors, diabetes mellitus, liver kidney disease, nephrotic syndrome, hypothyroidism, and medications that increase the triglycerides levels. This class 1 recommendation. Class 2 recommendation, in adults 40 to 75 years of age with moderate to severe hypertriglyceridemia and atherosclerotic risk of 7.5, it is reasonable to reevaluate the cardiac risk after lifestyle secondary factors are addressed and to consider persistently elevated triglyceride levels as a factor favoring initiation or intensification of statin therapy.
Because of many patients that increase the triglycerides?
Sir, those are steroids, some diuretics, then.
I think androgens.
Yes, androgens and. Class 2 recommendation says for age group of 40 to 75 years of age with severe hypertriglyceridemia, fasting triglyceride level is more than 500 and risk of 7.5 or higher, it is reasonable to address the reversible causes of high triglycerides and to initiate the statin therapy. Another recommendation says that with severe hypertriglyceridemia and especially fasting triglycerides more than 1000, it is reasonable to identify and address other causes of hypertriglyceridemia, and if triglyceride levels are persistently elevated or increasing, to further reduce the triglyceride levels by implementation of very low fat diet, lifestyle modification, avoidance of refined carbohydrates, alcohol, consumption of omega 3 fatty acids, and if necessary to prevent the acute pancreatitis, fibrate therapy has to be started, as fibrates are first class indication for high triglyceride levels. Issues specific to women, these are the class 1 recommendations. In women such who has premature menopause, history of pregnancy associated disorders, we should discuss the lifestyle intervention and the potential for benefit of statin therapy. This is one recommendation. Another recommendation, women of childbearing age who are treated with statin therapy and are sexually active should be counseled to use a reliable form of contraception. And another form, another recommendation, women of childbearing age with hypercholesterolemia who plan to become pregnant should stop the statin therapy 1 to 2 months before pregnancy is attempted. Or if they become pregnant while on statin, should have the statin stopped as soon as the pregnancy is discovered. So statins are contraindicated in pregnancy as they are teratogenic. Adults with CKD patients, this is a class 2 recommendation, 40 to 75 years of age, NDL say 70 to 190 and who are at risk of 7.5 or higher. CKD not treated with dialysis or kidney transplantation is a risk enhancing factor. So initiation of a moderate intensity statin or statin combined with ezetimibe can be useful for CKD patients of this age group with LDL-C levels this much, 70 to 190. 2B recommendation says that in adults with advanced kidney disease require dialysis treatment and not who are currently on LDL lowering therapy with a statin, we should continue, it is reasonable to continue statin. Class 3 recommendation, no, there is no benefit in advanced kidney disease who require dialysis, that initiation of statin is not recommended in such patient. For CKD require dialysis. Now statin safety and statin associated side effects. Class 1 recommendation, clinical clinician patient risk discussion is recommended before starting the statin therapy. This is class 1 recommendation. Another recommendation, in statin associated muscle symptoms, a thorough assessment of symptoms is recommended in addition to an evaluation for non-statin causes and predisposing factors of myopathy. Another class 1 recommendations, who are patient with indication for statin therapy, potential predisposing factors identification for statin-associated side effects, including new onset diabetes mellitus and myopathy, is recommended before initiation of treatment. And in patients with statin-associated side effects that are not severe, it is recommended to reassess and to rechallenge to achieve a maximal LDL-C lowering by modified dosing regimen, alternate for statin, or in combination with non-statin therapy. Another class 1 recommendations, patients who are at increased risk of diabetes mellitus, new onset diabetes mellitus, it is recommended to continue statin therapy with added emphasis on risk benefits and core principles to of regular moderate intensity physical activity. And another recommendation says that in patients treated with statins, recommended to measure creatinine kinase levels in individuals with severe statin associated muscle symptoms, muscle weakness, and to measure liver transaminase to rule out the hepatotoxicity and statin induced muscle myopathy. This class 1 recommendation, CPK, the creatinine kinase levels measurement. Another class 1 recommendation says that patients who are at increased atherosclerotic disease risk with chronic and stable liver disease, when appropriately indicated, it is reasonable to use statins after obtaining baseline measurements and determining a schedule of monitoring and safety check. Do a recommendation, patient who are increased risk of atherosclerotic disease risk with severe statin-associated muscle symptoms or recurrent statin-associated muscle symptoms, despite appropriate statin rechallenge, it is reasonable to use RCT1 non-statin therapy that is likely to provide the net clinical benefit over the statin therapy. Now, class 3, no benefits. Coenzyme Q10 is not recommended for routine use in patients with myopathy, statin-induced myopathy. And in patient treated with statins, routine measurement of creatine kinase levels are also not useful with transaminase levels. These are the important recommendations, ACC recommendations that we discussed today. Top 10, just quickly we'll revise the top 10 take home messages of these guidelines. First important message is to in all individuals emphasize a healthy heart healthy lifestyle across the life course. This is the first, healthy heart lifestyle. Second is, in clinical atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease, reduce the low density lipoprotein levels with high intensity statin therapy or maximally tolerated statin therapy with the target to lower the LDL-C levels by more than 50%. Third, in very high risk atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease, use a LDL-C threshold of 70 to consider the addition of non-statin to statin. That is, when there is major atherosclerotic cardiovascular event or one there are multiple high risk conditions, these are the high risk, very high risk category. In very high risk patients, it is reasonable to add ezetimibe to maximally tolerated statin therapy when LDL-C levels remains more than 75, that is after evaluation of 3 to 6 weeks. And in patients of this category whose LDL levels remain more than 70, for on maximally tolerated statin or ezetimibe therapy, adding a PCSK9 inhibitor is reasonable, although the long-term safety is uncertain. Only one drug is available, Ivolumab, which is very costly, PCSK9 inhibitor in India. Fourth is, in severe primary hypercholesterolemia, LDL-C more than 190, without calculating any kind of risk, begin high-intensity statin therapy straight away. And if the LDL-C levels more than 100, non-statin therapy is reasonable. And on these two, LDL-C levels on statin plus ezetimibe remains more than 100 and patient has multiple risk factors, PCSK9 inhibitor may be considered.
So that was in which age group?
In primary severe hypercholesterolemia, irrespective of 40 to 75. I think more than 20 years of older, starting slides, primary hypercholesterolemia. In patients 40 to 75 years of age with diabetes mellitus and LDL-C levels of more than 70, start a moderate intensity statin therapy without calculating atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease risk. In adults 40 to 75 years of age, evaluated for primary primary atherosclerotic vascular disease prevention. Have a clinician-patient risk discussion before starting the statin therapy. It should include a review of major risk factors, that is diabetes, elevated blood pressure, smoking, and calculated 10-year risk. In adults 75 years of age, without the diabetes mellitus and LDL-C levels of more than 70, now here comes the risk, that is of more than or equal to 7.5%. Start a moderate intensity statin if a discussion of treatment option favors the statin therapy. Risk enhancing factor favor the statin therapy. If risk status is uncertain, consider using coronary artery calcium to improve the specificity. If statins are indicated, what are the targets? Targets to reduce the LDL-C levels are by 30%. And if a 10-year risk is a very high risk category, reduce the LDL-C levels by more than equal to 50%. In adults 40 to 75 years of age without diabetes and a 10-year risk of 7, more intermediate risk category, risk enhancing factor favors the initiation of statin therapy. In adults 40 to 75 years of age without a diabetes mellitus and with LDL-C levels of 70 to 190 and a risk of 7.5 to 20%. Decision about statin therapy is uncertain. Again, the coronary artery calcium score has to be calculated. If zero, statin therapy can should be withheld or delayed, except in smokers or diabetes mellitus or who has strong family history of premature disease. And a score of 1 to 99 favors statin therapy in age group of more than or 55, and if score is more than 100 Western units. Statin therapy is indicated unless otherwise referred by the risk of, outcome of clinician patient risk discussion. And take home message for today is assess the adherence and percentage response to LDL-C lowering medications. We should reevaluate the patient on OPD basis. Lifestyle changes and with repeat lipid measurement 4 to 12 weeks after statin initiation or dose adjustment and repeated every 3 to 12 months as needed. Thank you so much for all the recommendations.